Buongiorno a tutti da parte del collettivo di Modena. Stamattina, guidati dalle parole della nostra amata madre, mediteremo su Sri Kalki.
Good morning to everybody from the collective of Modena. This morning, guided by our beloved mother's words, we will meditate on Sri Kalki.
Facciamo Namaskar ai piedi di loto di nostra madre, ci alziamo la Kundalini e ci diamo i sette bandhan.
We can do Namaskar at our mother's lotus feet, rise Kundalini and give seven bandhan. Sono la madre di Sri Kalki e il mio unico obiettivo è dare alla luce l'incarnazione che è l'essere collettivo, il Virata. Per questo sto lavorando con tutte le molecole che devono costituire i chakra di questa incarnazione. Quando la Kundalini raggiungerà il Sahasrara, Sri Kalki metterà i suoi piedi su questa terra e il mio lavoro sarà completato e lascerò il mondo umano. Madre, tutti i Sajayogi saranno cellule di Sri Kalki? È stato chiesto. No, ha detto. L'arrivo di Dio Onnipotente sulla Terra comporterà l'inizio di un risveglio generale tra la maggioranza dell'umanità, che non è in cerca, e incontrerà i Sajayogi, che dovranno essere la loro guida. I am the mother of Sri Kalki, and my only goal is to give birth to the embodiment which is the collective being, the Virata. This is why I am working on all the molecules that must make up the chakras of this incarnation. When the Kundalini reached the Sahasrara, Sri Kalki will put his feet on this earth. My work will be completed, and I will leave the human world. Mother, will all Sahaja Yogis be Sri Kalki's cells? It was asked. No, she said. The arrival of Almighty God on earth will bring about the beginning of a general awakening among the majority of humanity who are not seeking, and will meet the Sahaja Yogis who are to be their guide.
Portiamo l'attenzione sul Muladhara. Maganesha deve essere stabilito prima di ogni altra cosa. Egli è colui il quale rimuove tutti gli ostacoli, tutte le negatività, tutte le barriere che si presenteranno, tutta l'attenzione che vaga qua e là. Ecco perché per primo veneriamo Ganesha, proprio per chiedergli di proteggerci. Egli è invece l'incarnazione dell'innocenza. E più avanti dovete leggere nel Devi Bhagavat in che modo si incarnò sulla terra come Cristo e come stia per venire sulla terra con i suoi 11 poteri, come Kalki. Ovviamente Ganesha è il primo ad essere stato creato ed è lui anche a questo stadio, allo stadio di Kalki, il quale è alla fine l'Omega. È in dubbio.
Before the Pujana of the worship of Ganesha, nothing starts, because he is the one who takes out all the obstacles, all the negativities, all the hurdles that are going to come up, all the tension that are here and there. So that's why we first worship Ganesha, just to ask him to protect us. But he is embodiment of innocence. And later, you must read in Devi Bhagavat how he incarnate on this earth as Christ, and how he is going to come with his 11 powers on this earth as Kalki. Of course, He is the first who was created. And at this stage, at Kalki stage, also, it is he who is there at the end of it, no doubt.
Portiamo l'attenzione sull'osso sacro, dove risiede la nostra madre Kundalini.
Attention on the sacrum where our mother Kundalini resides.
Oggi è il giorno in cui devo mettervi in guardia, poiché mi avete chiesto di parlare di Kalki. Kalki è situato sulla nostra fronte. Quando il chakra di Kalki è bloccato, l'intera sommità del Murda, la testa, va fuori uso. Nel risveglio della Kundalini vediamo che se il Murda va completamente fuori posto, la Kundalini non sale. Tutta la testa si blocca. Persone così non permettono la Kundalini di ascendere oltre l'Amsa Chakra. Al massimo potrebbero provare ad alzarla fino all'Agnya, ma la Kundalini ricade giù.
So, be careful. Be very, very careful. Today is the day of warning you, because you have asked me to tell about Kalki. He is placed on our forehead. When the Kalki is caught up, the chakra of Kalki is caught up. The hole of Murda on top goes out of order. In the Kundalini awakening, we find that the Murda is all out of order. It doesn't rise. The whole head becomes a blockhead. Such people do not allow the Kundalini to rise above the, we can say, the Hamsa chakra. At the most, they might try to rise up to Agya, but Kundalini falls down.
Portiamo l'attenzione sul canale sinistro.
Attention on the left side.
Questo tempo che abbiamo è il più prezioso. E occorre essere molto attenti e vigili con se stessi. Si dovrebbe cercare di consolidare completamente il proprio essere nel regno di Dio e occupare il seggio più elevato nel cuore di Dio Onnipotente. Perché quando Calchi verrà, farà strage di tutta questa gente senza pietà. Egli è privo di qualsiasi compassione. Devo mettere in guardia tutti i Sajayogi qui presenti, perché Sajayoga è l'ultimo giudizio, non solo nel senso che sarete giudicati per vedere se siete idonei a entrare nel regno di Dio, diventando i cittadini di Dio. Questo è vero. Ma oltre a questo, sarà giudicata la vostra capacità di rimanerci. E se avete la rendevolezza completa e la comprensione totale delle leggi divine.
This time, what we have got is a most precious time, and one has to be very careful and alert about oneself. One should try to completely consolidate one's own being into the kingdom of God and occupy the highest seat in the heart of God Almighty. Because when Kalki will come, he will slaughter all these people without any compassion. I have to warn all the Sajayogis who are here, because Sajayoga is the last judgment. Not only that you will be judged, that you are entering into the kingdom of God, that you become the citizen of God, is correct, but apart from that, that you are capable of being there, whether you have the complete surrounding and understanding of divine law.
Portiamo ora l'attenzione sul canale destro.
Attention on the right side.
Ma quando parliamo di Kalki, dobbiamo ricordare che tra il ricevere la realizzazione ed entrare nel regno di Dio possiamo vacillare moltissimo. Ciò è chiamato Yoga Brahmasthiti. Le persone si dedicano allo yoga, si addentrano nello yoga e poi si fanno ancora sedurre dai propri pravritti, attaccamenti. Come sapete, il lato destro è tipico delle persone con troppe ambizioni, eccessivamente ambiziose, che desiderano conquistare il mondo intero e vogliono dipendere soltanto da se stessi, diventando maligni e cancerosi. Non vogliono mantenersi in rapporto con il tutto. Si chiama Yoga Brasta che si separa dal proprio yoga. Chi cade dal proprio yoga, perché Sahaja Yoga vi dà tutta la libertà di cadere come di ascendere.
But when we talk of Kalki, we have to remember that between getting our realization and entering into the kingdom of God, we can falter very much. This is called as Yoga Brahmastha Sthiti. People take to yoga, they come into yoga, and are then enchanted still by their pravrittis. The other side is, as you know, right-hand side people who have got too much ambitions. They are extremely ambitious people. They want to win the whole world and they want to become something independent on their own, malignant and cancerous. They do not want to keep their relationship with the world, but this is called as Yoga Brahmastha, where a person falls from his yoga, he comes down on his yoga, because Sahaja Yoga gives you all the freedom, whether to fall or to come up.
Portiamo l'attenzione sul canale centrale.
Attention on the central channel.
Ekadesha Rudra si manifesterà quando Kalki stesso inizierà ad agire, ossia quel potere distruttivo che distruggerà tutto ciò che è negativo su questa terra e salverà tutto ciò che è positivo. Pertanto è assolutamente necessario che i Sahaja Yogi accelerino la propria ascesa senza ritenersi soddisfatti della propria vita sociale o matrimoniale o di tutte le benedizioni che Dio vi ha accordato.
Now, this Ekadesha Rudra will be expressed when the Kalki itself will start acting, means the destructive power which will destroy all that is negative on this earth and save all that is positive. So, it is very necessary for Sajja Yogis to expedite their ascent, not to be satisfied with the social life or married life or with all the blessings that God has bestowed upon you.
Lei è l'energia dell'ascesa di Sri Kalki, Sri Kalki Mahalakshmi.
She is the energy of the ascent of Sri Kalki, Sri Kalki Mahalakshmi.
Diciamo il mantra a Sri Kalki Mahalakshmi.
Mantra to Sri Kalki Mahalakshmi.
Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Kalki Mahalakshmi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Deve Namo. Portiamo l'attenzione sull'Agnya.
Attention on Agnya Chakra.
Fra l'avvento di Gesù Cristo e la sua incarnazione distruttiva di Mahavishnu, chiamata Kalki, c'è un periodo concesso agli esseri umani per correggersi, per poter entrare nel regno di Dio, che nella Bibbia è chiamato ultimo giudizio. Questo è l'ultimo giudizio, vi avverto, e sarete giudicati tutti mediante Sajja Yoga, se potete entrare nel regno di Dio o no.
In between Jesus Christ and this destroying incarnation of Mahavishnu, called as Kalki, there is a time given to human beings to rectify themselves for them to enter into the kingdom of God, which in the Bible is called as last judgment. This is the last judgment, I tell you. And you all are going to be judged through Sajja Yoga, whether you can enter into the kingdom of God or not.
Portiamo ora l'attenzione sul Sahasrara.
Attention on Sahasrara.
L'ultimo chakra è quello del Sahasrara. È un centro importantissimo, poiché è nel nucleo del cuore, circonda il vostro cuore e tutti i sette chakra hanno lì il proprio seggio. Questi sono i seggi che ricevono la gioia e la trasmettono al cuore. Se siete nel Sahasrara, avete già ottenuto moltissimo. Avete ricevuto le vibrazioni, avete ricevuto i vostri poteri. È il centro più complesso. È Mahamaya, è Kalki. Nella forma di Mahamaya. Nel Sahasrara la gioia del Sahasrara è la gioia totale, perché lì si trovano tutti i sette seggi. Questo è l'ultimo giudizio. In questo tempo la gente deve decidere quale sia la cosa più importante. Deve conoscere se stessa e capire ciò che ha ottenuto. Non è avere un gran numero che ci aiuterà, bensì dei Saggia Yogi davvero solidi.
So, the last chakra is of Sahasrara, which is a very important center because it is in the core of your heart. It's surrounding you, heart. And all the seven chakras have got their seats there. These are the seats which receive the joy and communicate to the heart. In Sahasrara, if you are there, already so many things you have got. You have got your vibrations, you have got your powers, but it's the most tricky center. It's a Mahamaya. Kalki in Mahamaya shape. In the Sahasrara, the joy of Sahasrara is the joy of the entire thing. Because all seven seeds are there. This is the last judgment, and this time people have to decide what is the most important thing. They have to know themselves and understand what they have got. It's not just having a big number that will help us, but really solid. Saja Yogis.
Thank you.
Adesso adoreremo la nostra Parampuja Sri Sasrara Swamini Srimataji nella sua forma di Sri Raja Rajeshwari, colei che governa il Sasrara.
Now we will worship our Parampuja Sri Sahasrara Swamini Sri Mataji as Sri Raja Rajeshwari, that is the one who rules Sahasrara.
Lei è il grande potere che conferisce la vittoria a Sri Kalki, Sri Mahakalki Vijaya Shakti.
She is the great power who gives victory to Sri Kalki, Sri Mahakalki Vijaya Shakti.
Diciamo il mantra a Sri Mahakalki Vijaya Shakti.
Mantra to Sri Mahakalki Vijaya Shakti.
Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Mahakalki Vijaya Shakti Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Deve Namo Namaha. Lei detiene gli 11 poteri distruttivi di Sri Kalki quando egli è nel Sasrara. Shri Kalki Ekadesha Shakti Sahasrara Svarupini.
She holds the 11 destructive powers of Sri Kalki when he is in the Sahasrara. Shri Kalki Ekadesha Shakti Sahasrara Svarupini.
Diciamo il mantra a Shri Kalki Ekadesha Shakti Sahasrara Svarupini.
Mantra to Shri Kalki Ekadesha Shakti Sahasrara Svarupini.
Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Kalki Ekadesha Shakti Sahasrara Svarupini Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Deve Namo Namaha. Il suo vahana, il suo veicolo, è il cavallo bianco di Shri Kalki. Shri Kalki Ashva Vahana Maharadne.
His vahana, his vehicle, is Shri Kalki's white horse. Shri Kalki Ashva Vahana Maharadne.
Diciamo il mantra a Shri Kalki Ashvavana Maharadne.
Mantra to Shri Kalki Ashvavahana Maharadne.
Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Kalki Ashvavahana Maharadne Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji, Shri Nirmala Deve Namo Namaha. Lei è Shri Kalki. Lei è colei che risiede nel Sasrara. Lei è colei che dona la liberazione. Shri Kalki Sakshat Shri Sasrara Swamini Moksha Pradayani Mataji.
Shri is Shri Kalki. She is the one residing in Sasrara. She is the one who gives liberation. Shri Kalki Sakshat, Shri Sahasrara Swamini, Moksha Pradayini, Mataji.
Diciamo insieme il terzo mantra del Sahasrara.
Third mantra of Sahasrara.
Tvameva Sakshat Shri Kalki Sakshat Shri Sahasrara Swamini Moksha Pradayini Mataji Shri Nirmala Deve Namo. Mantenendo l'attenzione sul Sasrara, ascoltiamo la nostra madre, Shri Mataji.
With attention on Sasrara, we listen our beloved mother, Shri Mataji.
Today I'm going to address you in English language as desired by you. Even tomorrow, perhaps, we may have to use this foreign language. Today's subject is the relationship between Kundalini and Kalaki. The word Kalaki actually is an abbreviation of the word Nishkalank. Nishkalank means the same as my name is, which means Nirmala. That there, it is spotlessly clean. Something that is spotlessly clean is Nishkalanga, without any spots on. Now this incarnation has been described in many Puranas. He will be coming on this earth on a white horse in a village of Sambalpur, they call it, Sambalpur. It's very interesting how people take everything so literally. The word Sambhal means, Bhala is this forehead, Sambhal means at that stage. That means Kalaki is situated on your Bhala. Bhala is the forehead. And here he is going to be born. That is the real meaning of the word Sambhalpur. In between Jesus Christ and his destroying incarnation of Mahavishnu, called as Kalaki, there is a time given to human beings to rectify themselves, for them to enter into the kingdom of God, which in the Bible is called as Last Judgment. That you will be judged, all of you will be judged on this earth. The population of the world is the maximum, they say, because all those, practically all those who had aspirations to enter into the kingdom of God are born in the modern times and are going to be born very soon. This is the most important time because Sahaja Yoga is the last judgment. It is fantastic to hear this, but that's a fact and is the truth. Though you can understand that mother's love makes it very easy for you to get to your realization, and that the whole story of last judgment, which looks such a horrifying experience, has been made very beautiful and very tender and delicate and doesn't disturb you. But this is the last judgment, I tell you, and you all are going to be judged through Sahaja Yoga whether you can enter into the kingdom of God or not. Now in Sahaja Yoga, people come in with different kind of attentions or chitta. There could be people who have too much of tamasic vrittiya, or what we call the inertia, or the more sort of sluggish or slow moving temperaments. These, when they are exaggerated, people take to spirits or take to alcohols or to some such things which take you away from reality and make you numb with it. The other side is, as you know, right-hand side people who have got too much ambitions. They are extremely ambitious people. They want to win the whole world and they want to become something independent on their own, malignant and cancerous. They do not want to keep their relationship with the whole. You can see in this Kali Yuga how people have gone to their extremes. Some of them are very much indulging into too much of alcoholism, or you can call it something, running away from your awareness, from yourself, from truth, the beauty. The others are denying it. They are denying everything that is beautiful and are ego-oriented. So we have people who are super ego-oriented, very much conditioned and lethargic and lazy and absolutely primitive. The other side is that we have people who are extremely ambitious, dominating, and are destroying each other by their ambition and competition. These two types of people of extreme nature are rather difficult to enter into Sahaja Yoga. But the people who are in the center are easily absorbed in the Sahaja Yoga. Moreover, people who are less complicated, simple-hearted as they are in the villages, are very easily absorbed by Sahaja Yoga and they take to it without any difficulty. Say in the city you can see the result of so much of work of mine that there are hardly about 200 to 300 people today over here. But if I go to a village, the whole village, say up to 5,000 to 6,000 people come round and all of them get their realization without any difficulty. Because here people are supposed to be very busy, they have so many other preoccupations. They think other things are much more important than seeking God and wasting your time in such pursuits like seeking God. Under such circumstances, Sahaja Yoga takes its roots very sweetly into the heart of all the seekers. It works very spontaneously. You get your realization without any difficulty, without any effort, without paying for it, without going into any sort of strenuous exercise. But when we talk of Kalaki, we have to remember that between getting our realization and entering into the kingdom of God, we can falter very much. This is called as Yoga Bhrashtasthiti. People take to yoga, they come into yoga and are then enchanted still by their pravrittis. For example, an ego-oriented man or a money-oriented man or a man who wants to dominate can form a group of people whom he would dominate by his ideas and can go in for a fall, and the rest of them will also go down in Sahaja Yoga itself. This has been happening in Bombay very, very often. It's a very, very common thing that has been going on. But this is called as Yoga Bhrashtata, where a person falls from his yoga. He comes down on his yoga because Sahaja Yoga gives you all the freedom whether to fall or to come up. But if you go to any other guru doing any other sort of yoga in which purification takes place and where people are trained and disciplined from very childhood, in those yogas, a guru will somehow or other see that you are injured or you are hurt so badly that you have no connections with anybody else. It's like an operation. They take out that personality and throw him up. But here it is left to your freedom to understand that you have to keep to the mains. You have to keep to the group. You have to keep to the whole and not to one person here and there who is trying to overpower the rest of you. In Sahaja Yoga, anybody who tries to come up too much comes down, because in nature you have seen nothing grows out of bounds. Like human beings are of a certain height, the trees are of certain heights, everything is controlled. You cannot try to show off in Sahaja Yoga, neither you should try to make a different group or a different type of some special thing. Especially I have seen in Sahaja Yoga there are people who come up and ask people to touch their feet. It is most surprising that invariably such people get exposed in no time and one knows that they are gone cases. Because their chakras are caught, they are badly caught, though they may not feel for a while. Their vibrations may be there, but they go down and down and down till they are completely finished. Now this Yoga Bhrashtasthiti is the worst thing that can happen to anyone. First of all, you don't get your yogas. And if you get your yogas and then jump to this sort of a condition about which Sri Krishna has described, that you go into Rakshasa Yoni. Those who come to Sahaja Yoga must know that you have to stick on to one thing properly. Otherwise, what is the yoni left? If you die without yoga, maybe you are born again. Maybe. Of course, this life is wasted. But if you try such tricks after coming to Sahaja Yoga and try to impress on others that you are a very great realized soul or that you have achieved this and achieved that, all this nonsense that you have been doing before getting to realization, then there is a very serious offense and you are punished for that. This is the power of Kalaki, which is secretly working behind Sahaja Yoga.
Terminiamo la meditazione facendo Namaskar ai piedi di loto di nostra madre. Ci alziamo la Kundalini e ci diamo i sette bandhan.
We can do Namaskar at our mother's lotus feet, rise Kundalini and give seven bandhans.
Mm-hmm.